You are the carpet 3-1 favourite to win.
Oh, my gosh, thank you so much for telling me that.
I think you're doing a great job in there, by the way.
Yeah.
You're the new nation's sweetheart in many ways, I think.
I'm sure.
Do you know when people are getting evicted?
There's been rumours that it's early this week, but then there's Friday. I think it's Friday.
Your mother was on Big Brother's Big Mouth by telephone, and she was saying that you have not come out as yourself. You are not like this.
Has that been broadcast?
I think, as I've seen it, it must have been.
Oh, that's no good, is it?
We know there's a little bubbling with Calista. Don't know what's going on, don't want to know. Mm. All we're going to say is lock nothing down in here.
Do not.
Amelia, do you know that Jeremy is totally in love with you?
Totally. Yeah. Totally.
So, looks, I wonder, is he going to go for Amelia?
Oh, well, that's what you guys want me to do, isn't it?
No, I'm just stirring it up a bit, but...
Yeah. Just like everyone that's come in, which is nice.
How do you feel the housemates will react to the information that you have told them?
We never told him nothing.
Yeah, not one thing. All right, so Jeremy and Amelia there. Now then, I guess this is the debate. Would their relationship have flourished if the hijackers wouldn't be giving them leakage? So
no.
Therefore they're aware of what's going on in the outside
no.
world.
Amelia's a sneaky one, I think.
Ooh.
I don't know what everybody else thinks. I'm getting less keen on her as the days go by. I think she's very aware of her sexual prowess. She knows exactly what she's doing.
Mm-hmm.
She's reeling him in,
but in terms
playing
of,
with him. But, I don't think anything weird. I think he's just replaced the place of Victor.
Sure, but do you not think that the amount of information the hijackers are giving the housemates can't help but change that and alter their opinions? Because we see it in the summer. Every now and again, when they hear someone shout something over, then, I mean,
yeah.
That's leakage, isn't it, to a degree?
It is. I like it to a certain extent, though, if it's constructive towards them and the people they are, if it's making them better as a person. Like Victor, you know, telling him to calm down and think about the way he's talking to people, especially the people he loves, like his sister.
Yeah.
If that's making him think about himself and making him...
a better person.
Because I guess it's just an extension of when they hear the crowd shouting, we love so-and-so or we hate so-and-so in the summer.
Yeah,
isn't it,
it's going to mess with your mind a bit.
Well, let's go through the housemates and see how they've been affected. Anthony.
I think he's more confident.
Because
you know, he knows that all the girls love him.
Well, this is it, because we've had Denise Van Outen saying he's hot, the Hollyoaks girls saying he's hot, and Appleton and Mel just saying, you know, you're one of the favourites.
Yeah.
And you're hot.
Yeah, and he's a really good-looking guy. And
yeah.
He's a boxer, and he's hot, and he's a nice guy, and he's
What about, because when Nicole and Mel came in, they said you're the favourite, along with Amy and John. Can you see any change in behaviour in Amy and John as well?
No, Amy's brilliant. I love her. She's just such a cool chick, and nothing seems to faze her. She doesn't flirt with boys to kind of be cool with them. She just doesn't care what they think. She thinks she's a big geek, really, but she's not. She's the coolest thing in there,
she's
I think.
She's brilliant, isn't she?
She's a terrific narrator of what's
going on.
Nothing fazes her. That's what I like about
her.
So, John? John's just a lovely bloke, isn't he? I haven't seen a change in him.
Sure.
I think maybe he's maybe getting slightly paranoid.
Okay.
About what people are thinking, because he has this fast track.
Yeah, OK. Two housemates are going to go Friday. Who do you want to go?
I want Amelia to go and maybe Nathan, because I've only ever seen him in the hot tub. I haven't seen him do much else.
He looks great in the hot tub. Do you not like Nathan?
Just, like, chilling out. No, I like, but that, I think that's the hard thing about this. There's nobody that you dislike.
Yeah.
Everyone's quite nice.
Sure. OK, lastly, who do you want to win?
I want either Anthony or Amy to win.
Is that good audience we're liking that?
Yeah!
And who do you think will win?
Anthony or John.
Oh, you kept me, I was like, literally. Like,
tell me.
Thanks a lot, everyone. Now, yesday, or earlier today, what were we talking about yesterday? I asked the front row of our audience if I should go and chat to today's hijacker, Jimmy Carr. You'd be pleased to know that 8 out of 10 of them said yes.
You're so funny.
We did. Let's go back to 3:45 a.m. Yeah, boy! Jimmy Carr's in the booth.
I can't believe your luck. Hello.
How are you? All right?
Yeah, it's great. It's been a really good day.
You're a fan of the show, right?
I'm a huge fan of the show. I've been watching it a lot. I mean, I always watch Big Brother when it's on in the summer. And then, you know, the celebrity one. And this one, I think, is kind of the best one they've done.
How come?
Well, because they're young and a bit precocious, and they're all very likable. It's sort of the experience of going to college. you sort of see these sort of young people and they all get on with each other pretty well, even though they're all very different, and you kind of can have an opinion about them. It's a great thing about Big Brother is that there's anyone that watches it is a friend of anyone else that watches it, because you've got an opinion suddenly.
Absolutely.
It's like having 8 mutual friends.
What have you been up to today? How's it shaping up?
It's pretty good. I kicked off with just a very stunty thing where I got them all to wear a Flavor Flav style watch.
I love this.
And then they had to announce the time, who they were and what they were doing before they did anything.
In their own voice or Marcus Bentley styling?
Marcus Bentley.
Brilliant.
Well, because he's the voice of Big Brother. And yeah. I think when they're inside the house, they don't get a sense of how often like a Big Brother viewer hears a Geordie bloke sounding depressed.
Yeah.
And I love that about Big Brother. I love sounding the fact that he always sounds a bit, day 22, really, is it? Christ.
And what are they doing now?
Well, now
John's got a hilarious costume on. What's he doing?
He's dressed as an octopus. What is the matter with you? Have you not seen the show? What do you mean, what's he doing?
Well, I haven't.
It's 4:30, he's dressed as an octopus.
The show's like, it was going on right now.
Yeah, it's like CBeebies.
So what's he doing? Why are you making him do this?
Because he looks, so look at his bum in tights. It's adorable.
Yes, but why are they all dressing up as costumes?
What I've got them to do today is like a classic Big Brother thing. I've got them to pick what animal best represents them.
Yep.
And then they've dressed up as that animal. Okay?
That's pretty cool.
The idea, you get them all dressed in something crazy, and then you get them to have a fight. How am I going to get them to fight? I'm glad you've asked. Right? I'm getting them to rate each other on looks, intelligence and talent.
In the costumes or just as they are?
They all did that straight this morning. So they all came into the dining room, rated themselves from 1 to 8, including themselves, on looks, intelligence and talent. And we're going to play mates rates.
Brilliant.
So we're going to play a card game where they have to turn over and decide, is that person better looking or worse looking? Are they uglier? Are they better looking?
When are they going to have any alcohol before that happens?
It's a very good idea. Let's give them some booze. Let's throw some booze into this mix.
Big Brother staple.
Yeah, but I think it'll be good. I think because they're quite crabby, because they didn't sleep a lot. They stayed up till 5. I got them up very early. Most people, I don't think, come in until sort of 1 o'clock, the hijackers. I was in early.
Who's your favourite?
It's
from
a tough...
From today?
From today, it's got to be Nathan.
How come?
It's just really funny. It's just really funny and really natural. And he's got that sort of thing of just that incredible self-confidence. He's just like a really kind of fun bloke.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But Amy was really funny as well. Amy just sort of couldn't do the task. Just took ages, decided, and can't stop talking.
Do you like Amy?
Yeah, I think she's really nice.
I think most people, most hijackers come in, the one thing
I imagine
they love
Paul
Amy.
McCartney is watching this, thinking, that's the one I wanted. That's the one I wanted, the one who's really nice that looks like that with 2 legs. That's the one I want.
What a terrible mistake I made.
Yeah, I went for the old harpy.
Okay. Now, listen, speaking of lookalikes, you must have seen this already.
Yeah.
There's Liam.
There's Liam.
There's you with Liam's hair.
Oh, I'm loving that. Check, I could do that. Hang on.
How bad is that? Look, it's exactly the same. Oh, I love it.
I'm a businessman. I'm a businessman.
Can you say, I love you guys, at your nose like that?
Hang on. Hang on, we can't do that. I love you guys.
And then do a meow.